Well, it already affects roughly 50 million people worldwide, and that number, is set to triple over the next 30 years. Get with the program, Carlos.
But there is hope for dementia sufferers this morning, with strong evidence showing low blood pressure can reduce your risk of getting the condition. And joining us now is today medical expert Dr. Nick Coatsworth. Really nice to see you this morning, Doctor. So, do you understand or do you know why we're going to see so many more cases of dementia over the years?
Well, I think, Ali, it's a function of the ageing population and just the change in the population curve more than anything else, as we're able to cure other diseases of lifestyle. The degenerative diseases that affect our brain start to become more relevant, and I think that's probably the main reason, and all the more reason to put dollars into the sort of research that we've seen today coming out from the George Institute.
So run us through this correlation then between blood pressure and dementia. How does that all work?
So, Carl, when you think about it, you've got the tiny blood vessels going into all parts of the body, but then obviously they go into the brain as well. And if you've got years and years of high blood pressure, you know, the blood really pounding against those blood vessel walls, they become thickened and eventually they close off, and that causes damage to the neurons. There's no longer a decent blood supply and you get what we call hypertensive changes in the brain. So if you can actually control your blood pressure early, then it reduces risk. Remember, we're not talking about cure here, but we are talking about risk reduction. And the study from the George Institute did show a decrease in risk, even if you caught the blood pressure just 4 years before the onset of dementia. Wow.
So, Doctor, I think there's been quite a few trials in the past on the benefits of having low blood pressure. Did none of them include dementia outcomes until this one?
Yeah, it's a really good question, Ali, and actually there's a simple explanation, which is that people were looking at the reduction in blood pressure and they found you find that fairly quickly when you give someone a blood pressure tablet. So the trials stopped within, you know, 6 months, maybe a year or two.
Right.
But this George Institute trial was deliberately designed to look at the effect of blood pressure medications on dementia, so it followed the patients for a longer period of time. And that's what makes this so interesting. And certainly as a sufferer of high blood pressure myself, and someone who has dementia in the family, you know, I can highly recommend attending your general practitioner and getting your blood pressure checked and treated if it's a problem.
I went to my GP Eva a couple of days ago and just got a general checkup, as well as, you know, whatever's going on in my throat right now. But I had my blood pressure done and it was really good. It was like 125, whatever that means. How do people reduce their blood pressure if they've got a problem with it? And where is it a problem? What number are we looking at?
Well, look, I'm glad it was 125. That was the upper reading, Carl. That's I'm a little surprised, mate, but that's good news. There's a couple of little things that you can do if you're not on medication. And one of them is reduce alcohol intake to what we would call a safe alcohol intake, 1 to 2 standard drinks a day. You could lose some weight as well. That can often help. But most importantly, if you've got blood pressure in the family, pretty much nothing you're going to do is going to sort it out unless you're on medication. So you need to get diagnosed with it. That's the thing.
All right. And Carl's fine anyway because he's got good blood pressure. It only had one number.
You'll be right, mate. Yeah. You'll be right.
Was it 125 over something?
Yeah, it should have been over something.
Yeah, over what?
Over
maybe 80?
Probably.
I don't know.
Yeah,
I didn't realise Ali was a doctor now. Can't wait for her to run the hospitals. She will.
I've got some
ideas.
We've
got a job for you, Ali.
Now that you
mention
it.
Doctor, great to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All the best.
Right.